Thousands of welfare cheats are being caught out in WA thanks to mums and dads dobbing in a dodger to Centrelink. Tracy Vo is here now with our special report. And Tracy, everyday people are turning private eye to catch these rorters out.
Yeah, Tim, West Australians are reporting friends and family to Centrelink in record numbers. New figures reveal thousands of people have been caught out, with the government now establishing special task forces in Perth suburbs to catch even more cheats.
This man claims he has a bad back to get a disability support payment. This woman is withdrawing her dead mother's pension. This person, her dead sister's payments. While this fraudster told Centrelink she was a single mother, but here she is with her husband unloading groceries that her $80,000 in welfare payments help purchase.
It's an epidemic and it needs to be dealt with.
But now these Centrelink cheats are being caught out, not just by private investigators, but also by mums and dads who are tipping off authorities in record numbers.
Most Australians are very happy to support people when they're down on their luck, but they want to see integrity in the system, and that's exactly what our tip-off line does, ensuring that we can track down when people are committing fraud.
And West Australians are on board.
Maybe people are just fed up of knowing people who cheat the system, and yeah, I can understand that.
I'd approach them first, and then if they still did it, then I'd dob on them, I think.
We could be putting a lot of that money into a lot of other things, especially other people, maybe like pensioners even.
More than 100,000 people around the country dobbed in a cheat last year. West Australians provided around 8,000 tip-offs on potential cheats to Centrelink. And it's people like this 66-year-old who's using two fake identities to receive $90,000 in fraudulent payments getting caught. Fraudsters telling outright lies to get the disability support pension are also being picked up when they can swing a golf club or are a painter with a bad back but can still lift a ladder. Others, though, are reported by family and friends for lying about their current situation.
If someone's long-term unemployed, yet they're living like they're long-term employed, that may very well raise eyebrows as well.
The penalties are tough, including repayment of the debt, fines from $10,200 to $102,000, and even 12 months to 10 years in jail. The minister says cheats will be prosecuted.
They're effectively stealing from other Australians, and we want to be able to identify those people and take the appropriate course of action.
The federal government has recently set up a task force in Mirrabooka to stamp out Centrelink fraud. They're now looking at new locations across Perth to continue the crackdown.
If you've been doing this, cut it out because the gig's up.
Tracy Vo, Nine News.
And Centrelink says it's also monitoring the social media of people on welfare to catch out these fraudsters. Anyone who suspects a friend or a family member is getting taxpayer money they shouldn't be getting, they can contact Centrelink anonymously online or call the fraud hotline on 131 254. Tim.